The mixed doubles curling competition had reached its climax at the Innsbruck Messehalle, and having missed out on the chance of gold or silver, Japan and Korea now played Russia and the USA for the bronze medal. There was little to choose between the two in the early ends, but Japan's Mako Tamakuma missed with her stone, and that meant Marina Vernić and Kory Dropkin edged ahead in the fifth end 4-2. They were still leading 5-3 after 7, but back came their opponents going into the final end. Vernić was feeling the pressure and opened up the door for her opponents. And that meant they'd levelled the game, so into an extra end. They were having to work even harder for the bronze medal. At this point, Min Yong-yu and Mako Tamakuma had done all they could. Russia and the USA had the last stone, and it was up to Vernić to make sure her stone was the closest to the button and give her team the win. This time, there was no mistake. They could hardly believe it. It couldn't have been much closer. But a Russia-USA victory, 6-5, and the bronze medal was theirs.
It was awesome. I didn't know how it would feel, and I didn't know what to expect. But when I was up there, there was nothing really else that I could think of except for the medal and the joy.
Last day of the curling competition at the Innsbruck Messehalle, with Germany and Switzerland playing Korea and Norway for the mixed doubles gold medal. Michael Brunner of Switzerland was looking forward to adding to his medal collection, having taken gold in the mixed team event. But would it be another gold or silver? Korea's Unubi Kim and Martin Sesaker of Norway had gelled well in this competition and had put in some impressive performances to get to this stage. Four nations represented on the ice and watched by an international support. The game was played in great spirit throughout. Switzerland and Germany established an early lead and never let it slip. Pinpoint accuracy from Brunner in the second end gave his team a 5-0 advantage. Their opponents could only muster one in the third end and were struggling to reproduce their form from earlier rounds. In the fourth end, Nicole Muscatovic played the final stone beautifully for four red counters and a 9-1 lead. Martin Sesaker tried to stem the flow of points heading in the other direction, but Brunner and Muscatovic were bang on target with their stones, clocking up another four in the sixth end. Up. 13-2 the score now, and Kim and Sesaker knew it was all over. So, after their opponent's approval, time for a little bit of fun with the very last stone of the game, much to the crowd's amusement. There were smiles all round, the best team had won the game, a convincing victory for Germany and Switzerland, 13-2. Their moment was even better as they stood on the podium to receive their medals. Michael Brunner and Nicole Muscatovic, the mixed doubles gold medalists. Silver for the Norwegian and Korean pair, and bronze for the USA and Russia.
The feeling is very amazing, but I didn't recognize it yet that I won that gold medal. But I think in a few days I will.
Woohoo! It feels so good! Well, even though we lost the final, it feels really good.